Assalamualaikum and good day everyone. Before we go further into the big topic of sustainable development, I will give you the brief introduction to topics that we will cover throughout this course. The first topic will give us the definition and historical background of the sustainable development in a global concept. Topic 2 will bring us further into the definition by understanding the framework of SD concept, which explains the three important elements: environment, social, and economy. There, we will learn on its famous model and not forgetting the 3R concept, which one of the basic in SD concept: reduce, reuse, and recycle. Next, in topic 3, current development indicators is the title which it will cover SD by locally, regionally, and globally. Measure it in reality. What are the effects of population and poverty? What happens to the exploitation of resources? And what has done in the context of public involvement? Furthermore, on topic sustainable development, topic 4 is discussing mainly the reality of its application, resources management and green technology application, the land use and forestry, biodiversity and ecosystem, water resources, coastal and marine, lastly, on the issues of urbanization. In this course, topic 5 is about the management ethics and SD consideration, which includes the influence of human population growth, influence of existing resources, and conflicts between necessity and demand. And last but not least, it will be the topic 6. Here, the lecturers will discuss the topic of environmental changes, adaptation, and future of SD, which will cover the first on the climate changes and global warming, second, environmental education, the third, experiences and challenges globally and locally, and the last one, securing the right of future generation. So let's start our lecture of topic 1, the introduction. As we know, our beautiful Earth has become congested and populated. This is because population is fastly growing from 6 billion in 2000 to the expectation of 8 billion people in 2025, while we only have 4.4 billion in 1980. This is the reported from UNCSD in 2002. Species extinct at rates 100 times faster than the rate shown in fossil record because of the land use changes, habitat loss, overexploitation of resources, pollution, and the spread of invasive alien species. The picture shows the marine organism, which are the coral reefs, which destroyed by the effect of drastic global warming, making it turn into white color. While the diagram shows how high the temperature rises up since 1900s until the year 2000. Next, I will show you a 4-minute video which explains to you briefly on what is sustainable development.
This is Peter. Peter is a teacher. He's sure that he leads a sustainable life. He buys organic products at the supermarket, rides to work on a bike, and his lights use green electricity. But is that really sustainable living? Let's go back to the beginning. Even in the 18th century, people were interested in the environment. For example, Carl von Carlowitz realized that you shouldn't cut down more trees than will grow again to replace them. So he had recognized the basic principle of sustainability. Nowadays, sustainability is seen as a global concept. This can be explained with the help of the three-pillar model. The model is based on environmental, economic, and social considerations, which must always be regarded as belonging together. First, the environmental pillar. It includes, among other things, climate protection, which is widespread, protection of resources, and biodiversity. Also, food should be grown organically. That is, we should stop using pesticides. And farm animals should be given fodder produced on the farm. We must use natural resources more sparingly too. One of them is petrol, which we need for our cars. But sooner or later, this resource will be exhausted, so there'll be no fuel for the cars. This is why we're looking very hard for an environmentally friendly alternative, so that future generations will have environmentally friendly cars. Electric ones, for example. The next pillar is the economy, that is, business and industry. In future, at the supermarket, Peter should only find produce that's in season in his region, like strawberries in summer, mangoes from Brazil or bananas from Colombia and Ecuador arrive by air from a very long way away. Transporting them causes a lot of pollution. The third pillar of sustainability is the social element. Goals here include, for example, better education and training opportunities, equal rights for men and women, fighting poverty, and prosperity for the whole of humanity. One beverage manufacturer from an industrialized country has quite a bit of catching up to do here. It repeatedly takes over the wells of villages in India because it needs the water to make its products there. That isn't very sustainable. Peter doesn't think so either. After all, at least a little water should be left in the wells for the Indian population. So Peter tries to do justice to the three-pillar model. When he buys organically grown produce, when he goes to work on his bike, and by using green power from wind turbines, he really does live sustainably. But be careful. A lot of companies exploit consumers' environmental awareness. Not all the products that claim to be from fair trade or organic farming are sustainable. It's up to consumers to be well informed about the products they're consuming.
So generally, most definitions of sustainable development encompass the idea that there are three independent pillars of sustainable development: environmental, economic and social. So the slide shows the SD definition by the Brundtland report. And then there is more definition of sustainable development. Sustainable development stands on three basic pillars: the economic, social and environmental. As I mentioned just now, each of it has its own benefits toward the word of sustainability. The subtopic will be explained further in topic 2 of this subject. Now we can see from the diagram is the importance of sustainable development for agriculture, biodiversity, financial stability for our country or world, climate change, the city development, and most importantly towards basic human necessity. Last but not least, let us ponder the simple explanation of the word of sustainability and sustainable development. With that, it ends of our topic 1 of ST. Thank you.